I call upon the east and the air. I call upon knowledge and communication. I call upon the angels of the air, of knowledge and of goodness. I call upon Goddess Arabati of knowledge to bring wisdom to this spell. By the powers of fire and the flame, I summon thee. By the powers of the soul and light and illumination, come forth now, O ancient rulers of south and fire. By the powers of west and of water, and psychic energy in mother's womb, life, by the powers of the moon itself, I summon thee. By the powers of north and the great forest and the northern lights, come forth now and aid me in this spell. By the powers of the angels, Raphael, Michael, Gabriel, and Uriel, and Archangel Jophiel of love, I summon thee now and aid me in this spell. O divine spirits, ancestors, God and Goddess, come forth and create a sacred space of love. As thou wilt, so mote it be. May my thoughts, my words, my deeds, my magic, my love for others and helping Elizabeth and Robert find union together. May my thoughts, my words, and my deeds be a sweet of this of honey. I taste of this honey, and everything that I say may be as sweet as honey. I allow the energies of Mother Nature to make my words as sweet as honey. May it be as hard work and success paying off. It represents riches. May my words be as sweet of this of honey. Let the words I say in this ritual be as sweet of this of honey. As thou wilt, so mote it be. I cleanse and purify this sacred space in the name of love and of light. This represents a vibration of cleansing to all who hear it. I cleanse this place in the name of air. I bless and consecrate this wine by the powers of Isis, resurrection of love. O great one, mistress of magic and of beauty, the powers of Osiris and Isis, unity forever, the eternal love, I summon thee. Consecrate this wine for a toast and completion and celebration of success. With this spell, time itself will be Elizabeth in her favor. The time itself will set her free from bondage. This toast represents the final act of magic, the completion, the ultimate spell. I command you and the sipping of this cup to let it come to pass. So mote it be. Hail and welcome. Om Shri Mahalakshmi. Mother Lakshmi, mother of love, mother of marriage, with her greatest wish to be reconnected with the love of her life. I call upon you, Lakshmi, by the powers of the raging seas of passion clashing against the souls of desire. Come forth, ancient mother of prosperity. I summon you. I bring forth the mother, the
the mother of life, the mother of goodness. I light this candle in consecration of love, the perfect mate, a marriage, desire, sex, union. I bring forth you, ancient mother, fertility. I bring forth light. I bring forth goodness. I bring forth compassion. I bring forth the heart. I bring forth the soul by the red of the rose. The love is like a red, red rose, as deep as the red, red rose. I bring forth by the power of flame, power of desire, power of intimacy, and good communication, and a completion to all things. I command this spell by the power of love, that is the most powerful force, that love will prevail without any cost. Love will prevail. I summon thee now by this red candle to penetrate through time and space itself. My words are given life through flame, picked up by the four winds of the universe and of this world and of time itself. I summon. Dear Elizabeth, when I send you this package of your spell kit, to complete the other doll, the female that represents you, the male that represents Robert, I bless you with the three keys of magic that only Hecate can bring you. The three keys can only be found or given to you by two ways. One, another witch gives them to you. Two, or you find them yourself. I grant you these keys of magic. The three doorways, heaven, the earth, and the other world. Heaven, one of the keys, number one, represents the higher realm that we come from. It represents communication with angels and the departed loved ones. It represents a true connection with God that is unbreakable. So Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, Mother of God, please pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Amen. And amen. May she always find access to God by this first key that represents that no disruption, a strong connection with our Heavenly Father, the masculine force. The second key I bless you with represents the physical realm, the earth, access, removal of all obstacles. This second key represents the here and now, the present and the future, that you may have success in all your ways. I bless and ask that all doors be open to you. So might it be. This third key that represents the underworld, hell, it gives you access to remove the negative energies that are in your life. This is a one-way door. It only throws in and not pulls out. Only throw the negative in. It has no doorknobs. It has no entry point into this world except removing of negative spirits. That creates a vortex, a black hole to suck all the negative energies out of your life. All lies, all deceits, all confusion. This is a removal, a banishment, key of banishment. And when you use it by the power of God. Once something is sent to hell, it's there forever. This is the key to your liberation from darkness and things that cause havoc in your life. This key locks away your fears, your tears, any mental illnesses, any destruction of any kind, any lies or any deceits. I grant you the three keys and hope that you find where you need to go in life through the powers of magic and of goodness. So mote it be. Ancient Mother, Queen and Mother of Witches, lend me your power, Great One. Lend me your power and give completion to this spell. Near or far, by the powers of the winds and the earth and the fire and the waters, I command this spell to be complete. I honor you, Hecate, Hecate, Hecate. I honor you, O gracious mother, Hecate of the sacred fire, Hecate of wisdom and of truth, Hecate of rebirth and death and life, In resurrection, I call upon you. Answer me and do what I asked. Help your child. Help this witch. So mote it be. I command it by the powers of Hecate. Grant me your power, O Ancient One. I call upon God. God made flesh, God of man, and God of wisdom. I light this in the name of God the Father, the force of life, the staff of life. He is God, creator, in all forms and all names, the God of nature, Lord Vishnu, of magic and of union, of perfect partner, the perfect husband. I ask you now to come forth. God of destruction, come forth now. I summon you, O great spirit of life, masculine father. Grant me the testosterone, the masculinity, the sexual potency to create the perfect lover for Elizabeth. Robert is the perfect lover, and through this spell he shall become. With no dark magic, but good, I bring forth light, love, and the masculine force. Hail and welcome. I call upon the archaic past to shape the spell I cast. By the powers of earth, fire, water, and air, may these cards symbolize the achievement of Elizabeth's spell with Robert. May she visualize it in her subconscious mind through these cards as a timeline. I use these cards to paint a picture and desire of what yet to come. Into these cards I do direct great powers, powers that are drawn from me, powers that are made here now and forever. I summon the great spirits that work within me and my soul. I invoke thee, so may it be. I use these cards to paint the picture of what's about to happen for this future for Elizabeth. The Empress represents the Divine Mother in all her forms. She grants you time and space itself to grant you your desire. She offers the powers of the flame of the spirit. The Ace of Wands represents the souls of the fire, of the soul, of freedom, of heart, of mind. It represents the illumination. Both of you seem exactly everything clearly. The universe represents the magic rippling through and never stopping. The universe is a vast place. It never ends. It keeps going on and on forever. The spell will become eternal, just like space, just like the universe, rippling back and forth through many times, many dimensions, many planets. The vibration of my voice will go on forever to complete this spell. The Nine of Cups represents a wish that is granted, a toast in celebration. It represents fruit of the vine and success and fulfillment. The Ten of Cups represents the supreme happiness, the final outcome, the final chapter of eternal love and bliss forever and ever. May the smell of roses follow you wherever you go. I hope that you look upon this spell as a good omen and something that will be with you for the rest of your life. It will never end. Your outcome is the lovers. The great marriage, two become one, the final bliss, heavenly bliss, celestial sex and desire. The lover's card will be as red as the rose of passion and desire. Marriage between two people. I grant this to you with a pure heart that you may find what you seek. The Woman of Cups represents you in rejoice, tears of happiness and of goodness, A smile on your face, tears of joy, the powers of the ocean, the beauty of the rose. This has finally been granted to you. It is done. It is done. It is done. So mote it be.
Hello everybody, I'm going to show you how to make a voodoo love doll for one of my clients, Elizabeth and Robert. Today we're going to make a love doll for Robert, who she seeks, Elizabeth seeks is Robert. So we're going to stuff this with some herbal blends of lavender, rose, I put rice that represents a grounding relationship, mandrake to give it full life, verbena, some ginger, some cloves to spice things up and to speed things up quickly, some cinnamon, essential oils of jasmine, some vanilla, some dragon's blood, some wisteria. You gotta find your own, be creative, and this is what I'm gonna use to stuff in the doll. It has to be all natural. But before we start, you have to have a picture of the person. And unfortunately, I can't show you the individual. But on the back of this picture, I have put the spell to activate the soul of the person. And I'm going to read this right now. As I light this flame, I call upon and give life and soul to this doll by the power of this white candle. This picture gives life and soul to this doll of love, awakens Robert from his sleep, and comes forth. It represents blessings upon him, protection from negative energies. I summon thee now and bring forth life to this doll. Now, you can fold it up. You're not going to ever see it again because you're going to sew it up, so we're going to go ahead and I'm going to fold this up kind of neatly because I wanted to give it some shape to this doll. And I can show you half of it right here. This is what his lower picture looks like. You know, so you can't tell who it is, but you can see it's a person. And this just gives a personalization to this doll. Now, sometimes it's good to have hairs or blood or fingernails of the person because it kind of focuses in on the individual. After that, I'm going to stuff it with some rose petals, the herb blend that I made. Because I want him to constantly think of love and be good to her, that there will be peace between both of them. I'm gonna add a date of life for the head, so we could stuff that up there, so it gives it some structure. See, it's already starting to come to life, right here. It's already starting to come to life. So make sure you stuff this pretty good, and think of love and positive things. Robert falling in love with Elizabeth. True love and true light, it's the only way to be. After you do that, I'm going to add some other things, and I'll get right back at you. See you in just a second, and I'll be back with the other ingredients and how to bless and activate the doll.
Now, after you've got this mixture, I'm going to activate this doll for what it really needs. So first, I'm going to put this evergreen tree that represents everlasting life and love. And so I'm going to put that in there. I place this acorn that represents oak, sowing old oaks. It represents sexuality and potency and stamina and everything that Robert needs to complete the sexual cycle and be very pleasing to Elizabeth and be fertile and having desire towards her to create love and life. And it's very much a part of life, and we need that. So I place this acorn near the genitalia that represents sexual potency for him and awesome sex between them both, that it will never fade or, die out. Then I'm going to activate this bloodstone that represents his heart. And I call forth the soul of Robert, his heart, that it will always be searching for Elizabeth, that he'll never give up on her, that no matter who he's with, he'll still think of Elizabeth. His heart will yearn. He will have a hunger that he's never had before. This stone will repeat this constantly and knock on his heart forever and forever. I give forth life and blood and heartbeat and breath. This represents his heart. Giving life to this doll and repeating the spell and the words that I say throughout eternity itself. After that, you need to add a bay leaf with his name on it. This gives the name to the doll and protection. And then you sew it up, and I'll get back to that and we can finish the spell. So I must finish this, sew it up, and we can finish the rest of the spell.
Hair draws she to thee, the one towards the another, such as love that feels the attraction. This spell I give power to thee through this flame. I call upon life itself. Candle burn draws ever near. Power is precision. Ever does she pull. Ever does he pull towards each other. The days are long and yearning for him. Her nights are filled with desire. His nights are filled with desire. To be with one another is all it shall be. Her wish, Elizabeth's wish, for none of the angels, the spirits, the ancestors, the God and God shall rest, for no rest shall find until beside him does she lie. His ever wish she moves to fill, to serve, to live, not die. She cannot fight and pull as strong, nor would she think to fight. I bring forth fire and soul to this doll. She wishes him to be right next to him. The journey will never end. Where the sun goes up, shall his love be by him. Where the sun goes down, there will she be as well. I bring forth this doll and give life and activate it, that all that she wants comes to her. I bring forth life and of goodness. Ribbons bind and intertwine, your heart linked to mine, Elizabeth's heart, for you and I will draw and come near, for you I yearn, for me you burn, I bring forth and life to this spell, I call upon the ancient rites to bring forth what I desire. To bring forth life, to bring forth goodness, to bring forth the ever-existing heart of passion. By the powers of this flame, all shall proclaim. By the powers of this flame, I draw near Robert and Elizabeth. Elizabeth, when you receive your spell, you shall fill it with the herb kit that I gave you. You shall place inside everything that represents you. You will sew up the back, and you will sew the two together. With this, you will tie with the red bow or red string that represents the hearts that are intertwined, a hand fasting, a spiritual marriage that could never be broken, no matter where he is, near or far, no matter who he's with or talking to, no matter who he's living with. He can never rest until he's with you and beside you. I call upon those forces to give life to this doll.
Mother, goddess, moon above, bring Elizabeth her own true love. Mother, goddess, moon above, bring Elizabeth her own true love. Mother, goddess, moon above, bring Elizabeth her own true love. By the powers that bind, let this be true. Send Elizabeth her love without delay. I call upon thee now to bring forth life to this doll that draws Robert near. Mother, goddess, moon above, bring Elizabeth her own true love. His name is Robert. She loves him so. Protect him by day. Protect him by night. Protect him when he's not in her sight. Protect him from those who might steal him away, tempt him, harm him in any way. As I beg and as I pray, bring Elizabeth's love this day. As thou wilt, so mote it be. I bring life to this doll, and breath and truth by the powers of this flame. I drink in toasting of this spell, that all shall be well. I call upon thy forces of nature, that this spell is sealed by the drinking of this wine. So mote it be. Grant our children life and happiness. Send forth the good south winds. Send forth the breath over the waters, that our world may be beautiful, our people may thrive. Far off over there, Sun Father awakens and climbs up the ladder, leaving his resting place. May all roads be complete. May we all grow old. May our old little ones know that sweet smell of the sacred breath of life. May our all children find their way through life's maze, that everyone may be complete their journey. Sit down, remain here, give us the best gift is rejoice. Think positive and allow this spell to come to pass. Time is your friend. We inhale the sweet smell of the sacred breath through our prayers. I inhale and smell the sweet smell of the roses. We'll follow Elizabeth wherever she goes. We toast.